of South Carolina well. He goes on television. I've never seen a guy on television knocking me all the time. It's hard to believe I win everything in a landslide. This guy goes on television. Then he talks about, I know more about the military than Trump. I've been dealing with it for years. Yeah, for years. And that's why we can't beat ISIS. For years. They deal for years. We need new thinking. So he fails with his campaign horribly. He then endorses somebody else, and then he endorses Bush, and he endorses everybody. He's like bad luck. As soon as he endorses the people, they drop out. And then I see him on television knocking me. You know, you're supposed to be coming together. Paul Ryan, I don't know what happened. I don't know. He called me 2-3 weeks ago. It was a very nice conversation. He was congratulating me. This was before we had the ultimate victory, but he was congratulating me on doing so well. I figured routinely he'd be behind it. And he, the other day, just did a big surprise because I have had so many endorsements. I mean, today, a lot of them. Bob Dole came in. Dick Cheney came in. Many congressmen came in. Many senators come in. And we've had tremendous endorsements from a lot of people, both current and people that were here and highly respected people. And, you know, Rick Perry, as an example, he came in, and I've always liked him. But he's a tough competitor, and he fought hard, and he was rough on me, right? He got up. Remember, he went to Washington and made a speech for a half an hour, a speech about Donald Trump. He said, I'm a cancer on the Republican Party. No, that's the bad news. Let me tell you the good news. So yesterday, he endorsed me. And I like him. I do like him. I forgot about the 1 hour where he went wild. Okay, get her. But he said, one of the most talented or brilliant or something candidates ever to run for the presidency in the history of the presidency. So you have that statement and then you have this statement. There's a big difference. That's a big gap. But I appreciate it. And I like Rick Perry and he's a good man and I appreciate that he did that. But the one that we're surprised at, and I'm not surprised with the Bush family in all fairness because I've been very critical of what happened during the term. So I'm not surprised. And Jeb, we hit hard. Do we agree? But what people don't say is that he hit me hard. He spent $14 million on negative ads. So people will say, you weren't nice to the Bush family. Guy spent $14 million on negative ads. I didn't spend anything on negative ads on him. It really tells you when somebody can spend $14 million on negative ads, it sort of says, like, do ads have any power? You know, I would go up to New Hampshire before the vote. The best was Florida. They spent, I think, $28 million on negative ads. They spent thousands and thousands. You know the total negative ads? Have you seen it on television? 66,000 negative ads. I want to see Pete get 66,000 negative ads. Pete, you wouldn't be standing. You'd say, I'm going home. I'm leaving. I'm going home. Pete, 66,000 negative ads, over $100 million. And I'm leading by a lot. It was a landslide. In fact, it's over. I don't know. So I don't know what it means. But I tell the story. I'm in Florida, and I had a tough race against Marco, and I like Marco. I like everybody once it's over. I like. But Marco was very popular in Florida and is very popular. And I was down, and I own Trump National Doral. And they're having the big golf tournament. And Adam Scott from Australia is one of the top couple of golfers of the world. He's phenomenal. Long, straight, everything, does everything. He ends up winning with a phenomenal chip shot, almost goes in the water. The 18th hole at Doral is the hardest hole on the PGA Tour. It's considered the toughest hole. It averages like 4.8, which is impossible for a par four, right? So Adam Scott hits a good drive, then he hits a shot, and he goes left, almost goes in the water. He hits this unbelievable chip shot, a flop shot, 4 or 5 feet from the pin, sinks the putt, he wins the tournament, and all week long, I'm watching these horrible negative ads about myself. And we have hundreds of televisions all around the green. We have all these televisions where it's called the Cadillac World Championship. It's a big, big tournament. And thousands, tens of thousands of people. And I said to myself, oh, wait a minute, I forgot about this. I'm supposed to go out on the green, hand the trophy to Adam and all the people there, Tim Fincham, the PGA Tour. And I say, wait a minute, what happens if they have negative ads? They're going, because they said, And now Adam Scott, but before we get to Adam, we'll have a few commercials. Thank you very much. I said, oh, this is terrible. I said, turn the television. I told my people, get the televisions turned off. Turn them up. But there were hundreds. They were all over the place.